to the Armstrong Stadium for another week of football. Last week, the Pirates had total domination over the Livingstone College Bears, winning 59-0. Now this week, the Pirates are hosting the Monmouth University Hawks. Both the Pirates and the Hawks have a record of 2-1, but hopefully the Pirates can continue their home game winning streak. We're looking for some explosive plays from Alden Knight, Yaki Johnson, and quarterback Delman Williams. Kickoff starts at 2 p.m., and the stands will be packed because it's Greek Day and Parents Weekend. Make sure you guys don't go anywhere. I'm Rachel Prevett with the Pirate Sports Network.
Fake the handoff to Johnson this time on first down. He throws across the middle, complete to Bell. Bell is free, 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Ronald Bell. Williams barks out the signal, drops back, and he's going to take off and run again. He's going to try to make a man miss the 50. He gets the first down, diving across the 45. Snap. Williams gets it. Straight run. Williams to the 20. Williams will score! 10-5. It's a touchdown for Hampton! Another timeout. Williams does get the snap. Williams drops back inside the 10. Lost the football, trying to run it. Think he hit his thigh pad with it. Again to Jones, and he goes around the pile this time and slips into the end zone. Spot, kick is away. It's in the air. I think he's got it. The snap, handoff, Guerrero gets the line of scrimmage, spins, lost, fumbled the football, it's still loose, Hampton has it! quarterback. First and goal from the 9. Drops back calmly, looks across the middle, and it's a touchdown to their tight end, Jake Powell.
Welcome back, Hampton Nation, to the Armstrong Stadium. This is the halftime report. The current score is 16-14. This has been a battle of the defenses. Both teams have been struggling to move the ball down the field. We've had some shining stars in today's game who are Steven Smith Jr., a defensive lineman who has been doing an amazing job in today's game. On the sideline, you heard some of the players saying that if the Pirates don't let the Hawks score, they can't win. So the Pirates are going to have that mindset going into the second half of the game. This has been a very aggressive game, and the Pirates are going to have to keep that aggressiveness up moving on to the second half of the game. My name is Rachel Prevent, and this is the Pirate Sports Network. Pressure has to step up in the pocket. He gets a duck away from one man, gets the midfield. Oh, makes a man miss! 40-yard line, 35-30, and slides down. Gets the snap, drops back, looks across the middle, has an open receiver. It is a touchdown for Hampton.
It's a big one.
Hampton Nation, we're here with Steven Smith Jr., defensive lineman. So first off, I want to commend you and your team for playing and fighting hard throughout the entire 60 minutes of the game plus overtime. So congratulations. You guys did a really good job, but you guys were down going into, like up going into halftime, but like what was your mindset? Like you have to continue to fight hard, you can't give up. So what did you tell your team? What did you tell yourself to keep going?
at halftime, it was 16-14. We were winning. So I just told the defense, if they don't score, we win the game. And as you can see, that didn't happen. So we have to go in, watch the film, and get better.
And also, you guys have a bye week next week. So what do you guys plan to do to take, like, advantage of this?
Just get everybody back healthy. You see, we have a few injuries. I had a cast on today. So, you know, just get everybody back healthy and get ready for this conference run.
All right, so what was going through your mind immediately after the safety that tied up the game in the third quarter?
I just had to SQ and make the next play. I knew we were going to be back in the game. We were going to get the ball back. So I just had to stay mentally focused and get the team ready.
And also moving forward, you guys have an upcoming bye week. So what do you plan to keep in your head? Like, what do you plan to take advantage of this week?
Hey, man, just work hard, do the little things, stay disciplined, and just get back healthy. Everybody need to get back healthy, and that's it.
All right, Coach, now what was going through your head immediately after the safety that tied up the game in the third quarter?
We got to play defense now. You know, we had a two-point lead, and we basically gave them 2 points, let them tie the game up. So now we got to kick off, and we got to play defense to stop them. And we didn't do that very well. We didn't get a good kick, and they got a good return. And then they scored the next on that same possession to take the lead. So that's a huge turnaround, snapping over his head. Wound up in a 7-play, 9-point play, 2 points on the safety, and then the 7 points and put us down 7. So we went from up 2 to down 7 in a matter of a couple minutes. So that was a huge play in the football game.
That's all here at the Armstrong Stadium. The final score was 23-30. The Pirates fought hard the entire time going into overtime. The next game will not be until October 7th in Savannah State because we have an upcoming bye week. Make sure you guys stay tuned. Rachel Prevett, Pirate Sports Network.